यू कैन स्टार्ट प्रेजेंटेशन।
ओके, तो गुड मॉर्निंग माय फेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड डॉक्टर तत्वदर्शी सर. आई एम वंदन रावल विद हर्ष कंसागरा एंड सहेज शेख. आर एक्सपेरिमेंट इज टू यूज पासवर्ड क्रैकिंग यूजिंग टूल्स लाइक जॉन द रिपर, केन एनेबल, ओपक्रैक टू डिटेक्ट वीक पासवर्ड्स. सो इंट्रोडक्शन. अ वीक पासवर्ड इज शॉर्ट कॉमन as a or something that could be rapidly guessed by executing a brute force attack using a subset, or we can say a word list or dictionary of all possible passwords. So people often use obvious passwords such as names or their children's of their children's or their house number in order not to forget them. However, it is a simple password which is easy to detect. When someone uses a weak password, it is easier and faster for hackers to crack them open. So this is a risk for both the users and admin accounts. So moving on to John the Ripper. So John the Ripper is free and open source software. It has a great feature that it auto detects the encryption on the hash data and compares it against a large plain text file, which we can refer to as a dictionary or a word list that contains popular passwords. After that, it hashes each password and then stops it when it finds a match. So it uses three main modes of attack: dictionary, which is also known as word list, rainbow table, and incremental, which is also known as brute force mode. So it can crack many different types of hashes, including MD5, etc. So it also includes its own word list of passwords for 20 plus languages, which is a great support.
So moving on to the key features, it can locate Wi-Fi password information. It is compatible with a number of operating systems like such as Windows, Linux, Unix, and etc. It can discover likely passwords for Windows OS. It can also deal with encrypted passwords. So if the password is encrypted, it can deal with it easily. John the Ripper uses various password crackers and unites them into one package. So it will compare with the input hash, and if the hashes match, then it is a match, so it will give you the password. Sniff out data stored on drives to discover where password may be located. So it can sniff out your stuff from your drive, and it can check for passwords. It can be used for security to verify what can be easily discovered on your own system. So moving on to the attack modes. Basically, it has three attack modes. The first one is brute force mode. This is the most powerful cracking mode. It can try all possible character combinations as passwords. However, it is assumed that the cracking with this mode will never terminate because of the number of combinations being too large. Actually, it will terminate if you set a low password length limit or make it use a small character set, and you will have to interrupt it earlier. That's one reason why this mode deals with trigger frequencies separately for each character position and for each password length to crack as many passwords as possible within a limited time. So the second mode is dictionary mode or the word list mode. This is the simplest cracking mode supported by John. All you need to do is specify a word list, a text file containing one word per line, and some password files. You can enable word mangling rules. If enabled, all of the rules will be applied to every line in the word list file. Compare a given hash to a large but finite list of pre-computed hashes. If a matching hash is not already present in the rainbow table, the plain text cannot be discovered with that table. Moving on to the pros and cons of John the Ripper. The pros is that more options compared to similar password crackers. So it has more options to crack passwords than KNable and OffCrack. The user can make a custom word list file and specify permutation rules So as it says, a user can make a custom word list file of all the words that he thinks hold be the password. A user can write their own list generators. Patches are available to extend its cracking capabilities. The cons are it is necessary to log into an administrator account to install the software. So you have to be an administrator in order to install the software. Sparse documentation. Some experimentation will be necessary. There is no GUI support. It uses CMD, one prompt to crack the password. So it doesn't have a GUI. So moving on to the implementation of this.
Hello. Now I'm going to show you the implementation of John the Ripper to crack password. This is the site of John the Ripper. As you can see, there are various versions available, and we are going to download the Jumbo release, the 64-bit version. We are going to download the zip version because that 7-bit is not supported. Zip version, and then you will get a zip file. Once you extract it, you will get this John folder. I have renamed the folder for the easy so that I can easily write its name in the command prompt. Once you have done this, you will open your command prompt. Then you will change the directory to the run folder in the John file. Maybe. Now I change the folder to the run folder. To crack the password, first we will see the brute force approach. So now we are going to create a text document. Let's name the text document as Apple to easily remember it. And then now we are going to crack the password, we are going to give it the MD5 hash. So now this is the site to convert the password into an MD5 hash. If you write an password, for example, pass one, then it will now we will give you an MD5 hash. This as you can see, this is the test was the name, and then the front of it is the MD5 hash of the password. You will need to copy paste that into your the text file. Save it. Now we will cut and paste this folder, Apple folder, into the run folder, because that's where the program runs. That's where from where it will crack the password. Once that is done, now we are going to write John. Yeah, as it is an brute force approach, then we are going to write incremental and the name of the file. Our file name was Apple. Brute force approach takes a good amount of time because it goes through every instance from A to 1, 2, 3. It combines every type of combination. The another method, the one more method is the word list method. We will create a file for the word list method. What you are going to do is we will create a text document and then convert it to a RAR file. Let's name this as bat. And we don't need to write any password in here. We will give a password to the RAR file, to archive. Change the format to RAR. Set password as I'm writing easy password 1 2 3 4 5 6. So encrypt file names. I'm going to encrypt it. As you can see, the first method is completed. The brute force method. We got the password passed 1. To see it clearly, we can write show John. See, as you can see, this is a password pass one. Now, for the dictionary method, we are going to, we got that the file we created bat and the rar file. We are going to paste it into the run folder. Now to run the rar file, we have a command like a tar. Our file name was bat, so bat dot rar. Greater than. Now, once we write a greater than that, it stores the cracked password into this file. So we are going to name a file as hashes. So it will save the password into that file. Now we are going to run that command. We got the hash and the hash into the file, and now we are going to give the password one hash. If you press any key, it will give you the progress. As you can see, it cracked the password 1234 5. We'll say it easily. You see the file name, the file type, file name, and the password. That's how you crack the password using John the Ripper. Thank you.